Welcome back to Ewood Park after a first half in which Swindon Town have certainly given Blackburn Rovers plenty to think about. Notably, the offside ploy has frustrated Steve Archibald and company. Swindon fighting in the face of history here. They've never won a league game here. They've never scored a league goal here. But Steve White with an early chase, and Geno with his mind on the pitch and not left in the dressing room, which sometimes happens even to professionals at the start of a second half. Back from Phil King. 20 years old, signed from Torquay, admitted that he had to work harder at his game, and he's doing just that. No handball by Hockaday, it's just a miskick rather than any intentional use of the arm. Garner, that could be a foul, and is a handoff by Tim Parkin. Garner ready to react to a quick free kick, but in fact Blackburn didn't take it that quickly. Ian Miller wins the corner. Archibald's station is right in by the line. This is Reid. Hendry. Stayed in there again, Colin Hendry. Ardiles with a run and a shot himself, and that would have brought the house down. If Blackburn do go up, they will hope to keep Ozzie Ardiles here as a contracted player next season rather than the on-loan deal that they have now. Bamber, McLaughlin. Garner. Well, it was a very ambitious pass that almost came off. Hockaday met it, but couldn't stop Blackburn surging on with John Miller. But he's done it this time, or has he? Ardiles got it back. Sellers. Oh, Parkin's been a strong man in there for Swindon. Price going himself. Archibald behind him. Does he want help? He does. It's Ian Miller. Well, it didn't produce a strike on goal in the end. Price did very cleverly, and then after he was beaten by the run of the ball, really, Archibald swayed and twisted. But between them, they couldn't come up with a goal, which is looking more and more desperate for Blackburn. Blackburn warming up Alan Ainscough. Foley, hooked on by Hockaday. And White thought the free kick was his, but Hendry had seen which way the referee was pointing. A whole season's work could hinge on what happens in the remaining minutes here for Blackburn Rovers. Sellers. Here's Ardiles. Oh! He got surprising power, surprising for those watching, but not to the surprise of Fraser Digby. Through a crowd as well. Tremendous save. Garner. Parkin got the ball and not the man. But it's the Blackburn roar now. Hendry really camped now in the Swindon area. Digby, has he lost it? It looked for a second as though he might. No complaints from him. Waved the referee away. Wants to get on with the game. That's a good attitude. He was almost being strangled there and then was cut in two. Alan Ainscough first faced Swindon Town on his league debut. That was for Blackpool 17 years ago this year. And now he comes on at an important time for Blackburn Rovers in place of Ian Miller. Barnes. Bamba just trying to knock it in there for White. Foley, Barnes. Blackburn must remember their discipline at the back. Hockaday. Barnes certainly capable of operating on the right as well as the left. Parkin. White. Oh, well, that was very close. Steve White hasn't been a regular this season, but 14 goals he's contributed with that type of opportunism. Archibald. Foley. John Miller. Have they caught them square this time? Well, Hockaday was harassed all the way. He felt he was pushed. Some of his teammates felt that Sellers was offside in any case. But the decision is a corner. There's been so much drama here in recent home games. Against Leicester, Blackburn were two down and came back to draw 3-3. Against Shrewsbury, they were two up and lost that lead. Hendry, and is it from Price? No. Ainscough. Ainscough again, Price again. Anywhere will do for Bamba. Garner won it. Sellers. Bamba having to do all the defending himself at the moment. That's a goal kick, but that was the closest that Blackburn have come. Chris Price and a combination of goalkeeper and defender kept Swindon alive and frustrated Blackburn immensely. Ainscough, Sellers away to the left, good ball. Garner. Ainscough. Price and Ardiles for Price again. This is a real chance. Oh! What will that mean at the end of the season? Chris Price knows the significance of the nearest of misses. It was splendid attacking play by Blackburn. And that's how close it was. The move had switched from right to left and back again to get Price in. And Gittins and Archibald were the central figures in that. Archibald's got away. And it's a question here of what Trevor Simpson, the referee, is going to do. The Swindon players are most concerned about the punishment for John Gittins. Oh, Foley lending moral support. No sign of the card. There are 6 minutes remaining. Price, it hit Hockaday. Garner throws himself at it. Foley, bravely done for Swindon. And here's Barnes. Sellers trying to get back with him. A real sense of drama about the fixture now. Price. Past Calderwood, no. Well, the substitution has pepped up Blackburn because it's allowed Chris Price to play as an attacker. Well, Dealer is just waiting for Hendry's positioning because it's sure to be aimed for him. It's over him and it's over the bar from Scotty Sellers. It's been sweat and maybe in the end tears for Blackburn. Only the time added on for stoppages remains now. Price. Ardiles. Trying to make this one last attack a controlled one. John Miller. Garner. Oh no, for Blackburn. Colin Hendry. He could have hardly struck the volley better. Set up by Garner. And Digby was across. It's a corner, so he must have saved it. And he looks a fine young goalkeeper, Fraser Digby. He's in there again. But that's of no consolation to Blackburn Rovers. They've done more than enough in the second half to have won the game. But all they have from it, and a most wholehearted performance, is a draw. And I suppose that goes down for all the near misses as faltering again with the finish to a long season in sight. Chris Price rocked the Swindon bar in the second half. But Swindon's resilience has restricted Don Mackay's team to that single point. And off they go to Crystal Palace on Saturday for another crucial fixture. And they'll still be wondering then about what got away from them tonight. The final score at Ewood Park, it's Blackburn Rovers 0, Swindon Town 0.